Welcome to RP Hub. In this video, we'll discuss about how to execute or perform mathematical operations using Windows calculator. So if you can see here, this is a calculator. Once we'll open this, we have multiple options to be performed. Now I will show you how we can perform this operation automatically using Microsoft Power Automate. So before proceeding further, let's run this flow and see how it looks, the result, and perform this action. Then we will do it from scratch. The process has been started execution, and if you can see, the calculator is open. Now this will wait for some time, then press enter and perform the multiply operations, which is very simple enough to multiply any number through Microsoft Power Automate, and you can see it will capture the screenshot. So these screenshots are available into Power Apps images, and you can see the calculator image. So you can see earlier it was zero, it means it's blank, and now after multiplications we have the 48 is the output. Now let me delete this to screenshot and we'll build the flow from scratch and run this flow. So after running this flow, we will have the exact output available. Now let me delete all these steps and we'll build it this flow from scratch. First, we want run applications. So for running the applications, we will just drag and drop run applications and we'll select application path. For selecting application path, that is a calculator which is available in C drive, then Windows, and from Windows we'll go to System32, because generally these applications are installed under System32, and we'll search for calculator exe. So just navigate it to the calculator exe path. Here is my calculator. So I will select this path, and if you can see here, this path has been saved. I don't want to perform any other action, so I will simply click on save, and new variable will create it app process ID. So after that, I want to add some wait time. So generally this wait time will hold our automation flow for few seconds, and post that it will start executing. So this is holding and executions, because let's say if application is or system is taking time to launch the calculator, so generally this will wait for some time. Now after that, I want to take a screenshot. So once the calculator will be open, this will capture the screenshot and save it to file. For saving the file, we have to provide the file path. So generally we'll use this file path and we'll give precal.png. So precal.png will save the file into PNG format. So when the calculator will be open, it will capture the screenshot. Next, we want to perform click operations. So for performing click operations, we will select click UI elements. So I will drag and drop click UI elements, and for doing this, I have to open calculator. Now select the UI elements, or it means add the UI elements. So my first element will be, I want to multiply 6. So for doing this operations, generally click control and left click. So this will save this action into click UI element. Again, I will drag and drop. This time I want to press multiply. So again, control and left click will save this. Next operations, I want to select the second number. So here I want to multiply with second number 8. Now again, I will drag and drop one more click actions for final output. So this time we'll press equal to. Then we are done. So after that, I will again add take screenshot. Just drag and drop, take screenshots. So I want foreground window, and here we'll again save in file. So for this, again select this path, and here after cal dot png, let me change it to png. Click on save. Next item I want to drag and drop is close window. So this will close the window post execution. Title, I want to give the title as calculator. So exactly same thing. Click on save, and for this we will again change to foreground window. Now we are done. Let me save it and run the process again so that we can have our final flow ready with us. This will launch the calculator, wait for 4 seconds, then this will perform click operations, multiply both the number, show the output, and close the window. So that's the flow which we can generate easily without writing any single line of code in Microsoft Power Automate. That's the power of any RPA tool which is helping an organization generate automation flow without writing a single line of code. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.